I praise and thank God for this beautiful morning that God has given us to come in His presence before His precious word. For our meditation today, let's turn to Proverbs chapter 12, verses 8 and 9. A man shall be commended according to his wisdom, but he that is of a perverse heart shall be despised. He that is despised and hath a servant is better than he that honoureth himself and lacketh bread. Here the word of God teaches us how the attitude of a person changes when he gains wisdom. Remember, the word of God does not mention about the worldly wisdom, as it may puff up a person and very easily pride enters in. But we are meditating on how godly wisdom brings true realization in a man as to who he is and about the awesomeness of the Almighty God. Godly wisdom will help his feet to be rooted on the ground, as he knows he is nothing without God. The Word of God teaches us about the attitude of Adam after the fall. Though he was spiritually dead without the life of God, still he was trying to keep his head high, as if he is the Lord of his life and can survive without God. He even dared to point fingers at God, trying to tell him that God is the cause of all this trouble. But throughout the ages, we see how the children of God humble themselves before God, and when they gain the true knowledge of God, and God bestowed His mercy upon such vessels who realize that they are empty in themselves. But the world recognizes and honors persons when they see something before their eyes. They never even bother to know whether it is real or not. And man who loves honor and praise from the world will try to gain it through his vain actions. And God, who realizes the attitude of man, clearly teaches us that he that is despised and hath a servant is better than he that honoureth himself and lacketh bread. Or, in other words, it's better to be of no importance and have a slave than to act important and have nothing to eat. A person who walks on his own will feels good when he receives respect from the people. And for that he pretends as he is someone important, though he does not have anything to eat. And we see this attitude in every person, right from the one who is poor to the rich ones. When we look at a poor person who struggles to keep his needs met, we can see how they try to show themselves through their fancy dresses and makeups. They try to hide their real condition through their vain display. And even the word makeup fits well into this fake action of man. He tries to make up the things he lacks through his vain efforts. They may emerge successful in deceiving others, but they become a laughingstock before God and the heavenly beings. And it is the same with the child of God also. A child of God who really is spiritually rich will never try to show himself to others. He walks and lives with the authority which God has given him. And he faces each situation in his life with that boldness and emerge victorious in his life. Such a person may not have anything to display about themselves before the world. But even the enemy fears such persons. But on the contrary, the person who tries to show off to the world that he is rich materially and is worth something because of the blessings of the Lord may be naked and helpless in the eyes of the Lord. So as a child of God, let us follow the steps of the Lord, who has nothing else to boast in this world. A Lord who is the creator of the whole universe, the one who is worshipped by the whole heavenly beings, walked on this earth as a normal person and even labored with his own hands. The one who created man submitted himself into their hands to be tortured for our salvation. Let us also walk in the same path of our Lord. Let us not try to gain praise and honor of the people through our vain deeds. Let us not try to show ourselves before this world through makeup, just like the world around us. But let us glory in the Lord and the cross through which we have received this privilege to be called the children of God. Let us walk with authority in this world, which is ruled by the wicked enemy. Even though the world may despise us, let us always pray and desire that the name of the Lord be glorified through our lives each moment. May the Lord help us for that. Let us pray. Father, we praise you and thank you for this beautiful time that you have given us. Thank you for your precious word. Lord, help us to grow more closer to you. That's the only way we'll be blessed with that heavenly wisdom, so that we may be humble and not do anything to show off before the world and to gain the respect of the world. Help us to live to please heaven. Thank you, Lord. We give you all glory and honor. In Jesus' most holy name we pray. Amen. May God bless each one of us. Our Lord is coming very soon. Maranatha.